I've got 7 awesome tips, tricks, and functions in Illustrator, all of which are useful, and you're going to find that designers rarely talk about them. The first lesser known Illustrator tip I have for you today is a solution to a problem that's given me great headaches in the past. When we go to make a shape in Adobe Illustrator, so for example using the rectangle tool, by default the transform window is going to appear. This is going to become annoying over time, so to stop this from happening, simply click the top right corner of the transform window and then deselect the show on shape creation option. Now when you generate any kind of shape in Illustrator, the transform window is not going to appear. If you've had this issue in the past, you're going to feel a great sense of relief from this first tip. Stay tuned for more useful and lesser known tips in today's tutorial. Next, I'm going to show you how to add a neat blend to any stroke or path. So let's work on this square that we've generated already. Press C on your keyboard for the scissors tool or locate it in the toolbar. You then click once on any anchor point that you want on the shape. The idea here is to break the path open like so. Press L for the ellipse tool and make a circle by holding down shift. You're going to want to add a gradient to the circle, and the style of the gradient is entirely up to you. Once you have the circle ready, hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag to duplicate it below. You want the two circles to be perfectly in line. With both of the circles selected, go up to Object, Blend and Blending Options. You want to use a specific distance option and then use something like 0.5 as a measurement. Then finally, go back to Object, Blend, but this time select Make. You now have a sweet blend on the screen, and to add it to the stroke, select both the stroke and the blend, and then go up to Object, Blend and replace Spine. This will add the blend around the entire path like so. This can be used in so many different ways within your design flow. Just to quickly show you one more time, this works perfectly well on pen tool path strokes as well. So make the path, and then as we did before, head up to blend and replace spine. The third Illustrator lesser known function or tip is a preference that you can adjust to make sure your designs save better for web, regarding the use of typography. In the Save for Web window, you're going to notice an Optimize button. If you click this button, you can change it to optimize your saved file for type or for artwork. If you want your design to be optimized on how Illustrator renders type on maybe a text-heavy design, use this option when you save it for web. Next, we're going to look at the toolbar. Firstly, a way to improve your workflow using the toolbar, and then secondly, a handy concept for creating your very own customized toolbar. So firstly, certain tools are placed into groups or families. So for example, the pen tool has 4 tools in total in its family. We can actually bring the entire group out onto the canvas itself in the toolbar box like so. And this can be really handy when using specific tools for your graphic designs. When working on a specific design, so maybe a logo, you might want to make a customized toolbar. To do this, head up to the Design Tools window and then click Add a New Toolbar. Give it a relevant name and then simply click and drag tools into the toolbar. You can obviously save multiple different toolbars for varying different designs and workflow methods. I do find this especially useful when I know I'm going to need a specific amount of tools for a specific design job. You can head back to the tool window and manage your toolbar creations, delete, rename, and so forth. The 6th lesser known Illustrator trick or tip is one that you might already be aware of, but it's so useful I have to add it in today's video. When working on a busy design, it can be hard to align objects or even edit your design properly. If you press Command Y on a Mac or Control Y on a PC, you can enter into line mode. This lets you see vector paths even when they overlap. Now this is very useful, and you can leave outline mode with the same keyboard shortcut of Command or Control Y. The last Illustrator tip trick is going to allow you to perfectly center your artwork on the canvas. This is great for presenting artwork and making sure your artwork looks aligned and on point. In the Align window, you can change a setting where all alignment functions would align to the canvas. So, when I go ahead and align my design centrally, it will do so accordingly to the canvas. I know it can be annoying trying to align your artwork perfectly centered, so this is a quick and easy way. There are 7 lesser known Illustrator functions in today's video. If you find my content useful and you benefit from my videos, subscribe for weekly design uploads, and also share my content on social media. I'm going to be back with more useful and interesting content throughout this week, and drop a comment down below for any suggestions on future design content right here at Satori Graphics. I hope you have a great day, and remember, design your future today. Peace.